I don't like this hand a lot, but we'll draw out of it. We just need one land, right? Got him. Okay. Oh, beautiful. Exactly what we wanted to see. Unless our opponent goes land bone splinters, then that would be terrible. Have MTG in their name, yeah. Sprouting Goblin is just so beautiful, everyone. I'm a little upset that we lost that last game. That last match. Alright, we can tail swipe that and that, right? We can attack. And this is where I'm gonna have to do the right play instead of the cool play. And the right play is definitely to hold up Urtai to counter whatever our opponent does. I really want a Sprouting Goblin here. But holding up Urtai to maybe counter something really, really big and scary. And then be able to attack with Danitha, Gardener, Rager, and Urtai is definitely where we want to be. I think, right? No, we have a lot. Deathbloom Garden, Caves of Coils. Contaminated Aquifer, Haunted Mire, and a Swamp. Well, this is a little tricky. Also, I may have done things in the wrong order, but who's really keeping track? Also, the goblins we are the lands we sacked to the goblin. Would it have been? Maybe. But who's really keeping track? Oh, you mean the following turn? Oh, yeah. No, don't kill it. Uh-oh. What do you mean? It can only be activated as a sorcery. You're just chat? Yeah. Ooh. Oh, wow. Our opponent has some good cards there. And being able to get back what soul wind grace with this by sacrificing it to braids. That's pretty good. We have two lands at the bottom. Emyria's Outrider is lethal. It's unfortunate that our opponent can get back wind grace and discard a lot of cards to gain a lot of life. Yep. All right. That's exactly the card we wanted to get on top. Our opponent's what, trying to find a land? That's funny. Oh, Jesus. Beautiful. Talking about yourself again? Yeah, we did. I kind of love Phyrexian Espionage. Here, like, I like it and I want it. What do I take out, though? Also, Tokyo, did you see your DMs in the Discord, by the way? Or no, you don't have to look. Look, Tokyo. Do you like the new BRB screen? Good. And now we wait. We can keep this hand, right? If we get a third land. Braids, ooh. No, that's fine. I kind of want it to be potentially untapped. Okay. Nine. So I think we just go for this, right? Hey, Yorg. We don't know. Though we would really like a Danitha to happen, right? Danitha would be wonderful. And watching the storm? Hey, Tim. Yeah. Do we all have a favorite type of tea? So we're missing black mana, which is a little. Let's just hope our opponent can't kill Danitha, right? That's kind of what we're looking for. Because if Danitha can live a couple of turns, right? We can fight through. The opponent's best card was what? Herd Migration. But Danitha can do a very good job at fending that off, right? The cool thing is, if I do somewhat decently today, I can maybe try and play limited again. Amazing, right? 5,000 gems? Oh my, oh wow. So many gems, everyone. The trumpet man can, 'cause he mixes it with love and makes the world taste good. Ooh, I think we. God, I don't know what I want to get rid of there. Awful. I probably should have known better. Oh, wow. Hello and welcome, the Double Denitha Gamer. We also, oh, I was like, we also don't have green, but yeah, now we do. Oh, on R? Okay. Hopefully our opponent like does a really big, like fills the board with stuff, and then we can get a really good temporal firestorm going on. Okay. Heroes heirloom, everyone. We have full domain for nail. So we just need to protect it with Ertai and hopefully we'll be okay. That's a big Talarian Terror, though. Like, I think I'm fine with this trade. Yeah, that's okay. Ooh, that's not okay. That was not okay. Uh-oh. So what we really need is a Sarah Paragon or a Danitha. TJ. I guess we have another turn. Okay. Yeah, GG. The Talarian Terror, our opponent has a lot of really, really big, beefy creatures, everyone. A lot of them. Like, is there any way we're just supposed to add more blue to counter them? Oh yeah, destroy evil, yeah. Maybe we can get rid of an that. And, like, is Essence Scatter worth holding up? Like, it does just put so much more pressure on our lands. Eh, oh well. We're fine. We're fine. Alright, we'll play. I mean, fine here. I'll work with a perfect mana, right? Just don't have another Essence Scatter, please. Does our opponent have Essence Scatter? Boom. Oh, ooh. Okay. We have all of our lands, so maybe we what? What do we want? We need another white land. So we can double white. So I'll get the... Oh, God. We needed the blue-red one. I am so bad at this game. I am so sorry, everyone. Danitha. Ooh. Let's go. I mean, I'll keep this hand. Essence, scatter this. Essence, scatter this. Hey. I'll attack for one. I'm not gonna play nail into an essence scatter. Who do you think I am? Griffin Protector. So if we just tail swipe that. Oh, I should have gotten a white source. Oh my god, everyone. I needed to get a white source. It's fine. All right, wait, BRB. Yeah, sorry. I didn't probably make the best play that turn, but I had a DoorDash that I had to go. And, solve. Wendy's delivers? No, I got a Pokeball. I got a Pokeball. Wendy's the Pokeball. Yeah. 1,000,000,000%. Ooh. So we can do that there. I think we can pay the ward. A Snicker ice cream bar? Oh, I would, things I would do for an ice cream bar would probably surprise nobody. Oh, I have no idea. Go to 13. We haven't seen a Denitha from our opponent yet. Yeah, all of them? Yeah. No, I don't think that was that happened. Because we had to use Citizen's Arrest and the Deathbloom Gardener. What? Oh, wow. Heroes Heirloom was also my preview card, so. Yeah. A chroma who? Yeah. A chroma. I think I'm fine there. Maybe we could have countered it, but like, if our opponent does something for 2 mana, we can Urtai. Yeah, or we can destroy evil that. Oh no, we can't. No, that because I didn't have the white mana. That makes sense. I want to keep the Urtai up though. Yeah. That's why I kept the Urtai up. Cuz I could have played the Salvage Mana Worker during my turn to have the Destroy Evil up, but I think it just the Urtai to counter anything is much better. Like we're still in a really good spot, right? Because I think we destroy evil Denitha. And then we have Ertai to counter. Good game. Ugh. GG. I'm just happy to have all of these gems, honestly. So, ooh. This is a lightning strike target, right? We could, like, citizens arrest it later, but I don't want to play Floriferous Vinewall and just take that damage. And we also need another white mana.
There is a place for all. Every day, more rally.
Hey, Numskull. It is definitely going.
Every day, more rally to our glorious cause.
Oh, no. Well, Numskull, I do too. So, twinning. Ajani isn't necessarily giving our opponent a lot of card advantage right now. And so I think we can let...
Your defiance will be punished.
Hmm. two beast callers? Alright, this is Johnny has drawn way too many cards. Hey York, how are you? I mean, what combat trick do you have? Our opponent has Silverback Elder, two Beast Callers, and an Ajani.
We have played our part.
Very, very good cards. Well, that's also very good. Fighting it. Also has Prayer of Binding. Yep. Imagine having removal, though. This being a 5/7, like, how do we... Oh, Silverback Elder can also get rid of our Citizen's Arrest? Oh, wow. I didn't even know that was a thing that it could do. I think maybe... The husband just got me my iced coffee, everyone. So, go Team James. What? I am very confused. I mean, we do this. Our opponent maybe is playing around Essence Scatter, right? That's probably what's happening. Oh no. You think I, ugh, imagine doing that. Not me. I actually think we need to put that at the bottom. Because Outrider doesn't do anything against the Silverback Elder. Oh no! I saw that coming too. Okay. So what we have to do here is stack that, hope to get a tail swipe. Didn't get a tail swipe. Oh, that is disgusting. Oh. So, we need to get, if we can get Sarah Paragon, we might have enough mana to, well, wow, we drew very badly there. Very badly. So we want the Destroy Evil. No, we're gonna need that. I think I'll take out the flow stone. Oh, that was so brutal, everyone. But also, Migu, is that a good or a bad thing? Because from you, I wouldn't hate it, so. Oh, not like this, everyone. Okay. Let's get rid of. We're gonna get perfect mana. We're gonna not gonna need it. Hey, Isaiah. We are doing. What's our record? Are we 4-1? We're down a game? All right. We need white. I would like red, but we need the white. Our opponent's deck is very, very good. What is I think turn 4 Nihil is more important than Phyrexian Rager this turn. The awful thing is Quarian Beast Caller is gonna get really, really big really, really quickly, and we don't have really a way to deal with it, right? And that's gonna really suck. Well, I would love the Temporal Firestorm, but Lily, beautiful. Well, this is unfortunate, but I think we have to tail swipe that so it doesn't get any bigger. This can then chump and we can buy it back with Sarah Paragon. No. Because we wanted to cast the Sarah Paragon, right? So we need to use all of our white. I think, anyway. Oh. Opponent deck is very, very good. We know our opponent has another Prayer of Binding. And that makes things a little complicated, right? I think we do this. Yeah, I think we're 4-1 progressive, but who really knows? So what we need here is a probably draw a red source off the top. So then we can draw something with Niel. And we didn't. So we lose. GG. Oh, that was unfortunate. What an unfortunate mulligan, too. So what did we end up going? Four two, we'll take it. I'll take it. Claim prize.